Good evening, everybody. Let us start today the basics of microwave and antennas. Okay. In the previous class, I have given you a brief about what all you will be studying in this particular subject this semester. As the name suggests, it has got two different subjects, two different domains of engineering clubbed together. One is this microwave, which comes under microwave engineering, and the other one is antennas part, which is actually a part of radio engineering. Okay, these two concepts have been clubbed together, and a few of those concepts are there for your syllabus. In the previous class, I had given this task as it is visible on the screen. You can just see. I have written electromagnetic spectrum. Okay, this was the task given to you in the previous class. You should go through what is this electromagnetic spectrum. Okay, a spectrum is what? A band of frequencies. Okay, a range which will depict, a figure which will depict a different range of frequencies and wavelengths. Okay, in this figure you can just check it. I have marked different waves. And the lambda is specified. Wavelength for those particular waves have been specified. I have not specified the frequency range. Specifically, lambda has been specified. Here you can see in this total range of electromagnetic spectrum, it starts with, in this figure, I have marked and I have I have taken it from left to right. In many of the books, if you refer, in your Google, if you refer, it may be that the range is given like this also, from right towards left. However, here I have given in this fashion, left to right. If you see, the first you come across in the electromagnetic spectrum is gamma rays, then comes X-rays. You can just see, for gamma rays, what is the wavelength, then for X-rays and UV, ultraviolet rays, then infrared rays, and I have marked here for UV and infrared, this is the range for visible spectrum. Then comes the microwave range. If you see here, it's important. The lambda value is 10 to the power of minus 2. Okay, and then comes the radio waves. Now, anybody has done this work which I had given in the previous class? I had told you to please go through this electromagnetic spectrum. Neatly write this chart in your notebooks. Have you done that? Anybody, please?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, I think Firdaus is the only one who did this. Nobody else. Yes, Archana, Akshata, Minas. No boys are here, I guess. Rumana, Sajida, Habiba. Oh, Ehsan is here. Ehsan, this is your first class?
No, ma'am. Second class.
Oh, you have attended the introductory class. Then you know the homework, right? Have you done that?
No, ma'am.
Oh, I know it. I know it. It's as usual. So much of seriousness you have for the, you know, subject. And see, you people are very much bothered about no subject has been started still. And when the faculty is telling something to you, you are not bothered about it. Good. Who else? Boy, only Ehsan is there? No other boy? Okay, what about Nusrat? Nusrat, the last class attend kiye the? I want you people to be attentive, okay? Don't, simply mute the mic and the room here and there in your house, and after the class you come back and sit. I want the interactive kind of class. Answer me. Mubashirin, have you done the work?
Yes. Yes, ma'am, I have done.
Okay, good. Nusrat? What about
you? Yes, ma'am.
Umakye?
No, ma'am.
ओके कॉन्फिडेंस नहीं है आंसर में
नहीं
ओके सो
आफ्टर लॉन्ग टाइम
ओके ओके सो एटलीस्ट प्लीज बी सीरियस व्हाट एवर वी डू कोई गूगल क्लासरूम चेक किए हैं एनीबडी वेदर आर यू हैव जॉइंड और नॉट आई होप यू हैव जॉइंड गूगल क्लासरूम
Yes, ma'am.
I have sent a video there. Some 7 minutes video is there, not prepared by me. Some animated video is there. Please go and watch. Okay? In Google Classroom, I have posted a video. Okay, fine. Now coming to your yes. Any doubt? Yes. Somebody wants was talking something. Okay, fine. So I'll continue with the topic. Okay. This is about the electromagnetic spectrum. I have written few points here. You can check out. Microwaves are the type of electromagnetic radiation falling in the range of EM spectrum between radio and IR. This is very much visible to you. See, in between radio waves and IR, these fall. Okay, and here, as I have only mentioned lambda range, here I have mentioned the frequency range for microwave. This is very important thing. You should know when you are studying microwave subject, you should know what is the frequency range for microwaves. What is the lambda range for microwave? At least this much you should know. Okay. So it is 10 to the power of 9 hertz to 1000 gigahertz. Okay. Now, coming to the next part, the prefix micro in a microwave word, what do you think? See, whenever I talk about some name, generally the name detects some idea, okay? Agar kuch naam rakha hai, toh uske peeche ek reason rehta hai. Like microwave, jab ye word aap sunte ho, when you hear this word, the very first thing that comes to your mind is, ye microwave jo naam usko diya gaya hai, it may be that some micro ya to frequency rahega ya to lambda rahega. Because of that reason, might be the microwave word has come. Okay, but actually it is not the case. It is not that, because if you check out, it's a frequency range, it is in giga. And the nowhere comes in micro, because lambda, it has got milli. So the term micro, it is not at all associated with its any significance value. Okay, the name, it has certain history for it. You know who invented this radio? Who invented radio?
Marconi.
Marconi. But before Marconi, some person whose name is, you might have heard his name, Heinrich Hertz. Hertz, H-E-R-T-Z, frequency ka jo unit hai. Okay, Heinrich Hertz, he was experimenting on this radio wave technology. Okay, earlier to microwave usage, he was working on radio waves technology, and before that, all those experiments were they were modeled, they were based on some of the papers published by this scientist Maxwell, who is the father of electromagnetism. He is Maxwell. Okay, you have studied four Maxwell's equations also. They are the base for electromagnetic theory. So based on his experimentation, he was trying something on radio wave technology. During that, these people invented this microwave. Okay, and they are just depicting all this information, that video is related, which I have posted in Google Classroom. Just go through it. Okay, the experimental setup, how it was shown in that animation. So the microwaves, as they were related to radio waves, and you just you can see in the electromagnetic spectrum, radio waves, they are after microwaves, and microwaves are just prior to radio waves, like shorter than radio waves, just to indicate that smaller than radio, the word microwave has come. The probably if during this time, the newer, you know, the new age, during this time, if something gets invented, very much authentic, very much significant names are given. But however, in that age, when just to indicate the smaller meaning, okay, small, smaller than radio, this microwaves, this name has been given to this particular kind of waves. This is the idea behind the name of the microwave. So you should know this. So if somebody asks you, a microwave, does that mean that some frequency or lambda is having micro value? No, it is not. Micro indicates a smaller value comparing to the radio wave technology. Hence, the name is given as microwave. And I have given here, microwaves, they travel by LOS. What is LOS? You have studied communication. What is LOS? Anybody? What is LOS? Yes? Fedosh? What is LOS? Speed of light. Okay, reverse, in a reverse order you are telling. No, it's not speed of light. Anybody? Quickly. PCS you have studied, right? If I install two different antennas of same height, one as a transmitter and one as a receiver, you assume that, okay? You assume karo ki main do antennas use kar rahi hu, ek transmitter hai aur ek receiver hai, which are both kept apart say some many kilometers away. So communication kaisa rehta hai dono ke beech mein? What is the shape of the earth?
Line of sight.
Yes. Now, ये figure देखने के बाद पता चल गया. This is called line of sight, right? They should be in the same position. So, hence microwave communication, it is limited to certain kilometers only. Fine. It travel by line of sight. And unlike LF radio waves, LF stands for low frequency. Low frequency radio waves, because in case of radio waves, this happens. Radio waves, they do get diffracted. Okay, you have studied diffraction and interference. Whenever in between buildings and hills come, the waves get diffracted at certain angle. Or even radio waves, they get reflected from the ionosphere. You know that if this is your Earth surface, after certain distance, the Earth's atmosphere is divided into number of layers, okay, stratosphere and all, you remember, and the last one is ionosphere. So in case of radio waves, what happens whenever, say this is your transmitter, assume karo ye transmitter hai, jab ek wave yahan se transmit hota hai, when it gets transmitted, when it hits the stratosphere, because of the property of stratosphere, the waves gets reflected, okay, ye reflection hota hai yahan pe. This happens in case of radio waves, but however, in case of this microwave, this doesn't happen. Okay, only in case of radio waves this happen. So that's why it is unlike radio waves, they do not get diffracted or they do not get reflected from the ionosphere. This is about the microwaves. Now, next point I have written, radio frequency band and microwave band. Here I have kept the things blank. What for? It is a होमवर्क यस यू शुड आइडेंटिफाई दिस रेडियो फ्रीक्वेंसी बैंड. आपको शायद पता है ऑलरेडी वो LS लो फ्रीक्वेंसी, मीडियम फ्रीक्वेंसी, हाई फ्रीक्वेंसी, अल्ट्रा हाई फ्रीक्वेंसी. ये जो कैटेगरी है वो आपको चार्ट बनाना है. रेडियो फ्रीक्वेंसी बैंड यू शुड नो व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट रेंजेस ऑफ रेडियो फ्रीक्वेंसी. सिमिलरली फॉर माइक्रोवेव ऑल्सो सर्टेन बैंड इज देयर. नाउ इफ यू सी दिस figure electromagnetic spectrum, here I have mentioned these two things. Now what work I'm giving you as a homework is inside this range, okay, microwave has got certain frequency range, so that frequency band again how it is subdivided. Similarly radio frequency, it has got certain range from lower to higher, okay, in this range how again subdivision has occurred. So these two are the works for your today's class. This is the work. These two bands you should write it. I hope you will do this at least this time. Now coming to the second part of your subject, that is antennas. Just now I spoke about microwaves. Now I'm coming to the antennas. So whenever the antenna word comes to your mind, what immediately flashes? Anybody? Don't look at the screen, okay? I've written something there. Don't look at that now. So whenever this antenna word comes, what comes to your mind? TV antenna? Please have a discussion, else you'll feel it bored or sleepy. What comes to your mind when you hear this word antenna?
Network.
Network. Okay, fine. Anybody? Okay, Rumana has said network.
Transmitting and receiving medium.
Medium, okay. It is not a medium. Medium ka matlab alag hota hai. Aapko apna mobile yaad nahi aa raha hai? Jab antenna word sunte ho. Aapke mobile mein antenna nahi hai? You all are having smartphones, right? So they are not having any antenna? Hai ya nahi hai? Antenna hai, isiliye to aap baat kar sakte ho, sun sakte ho. It's a transceiver. It's a combination of transmitter and receiver. So you can just see on the screen, an antenna is the interface between radio waves that propagate through space. See, I'm talking about radio waves here, okay? So it is the interface. So interface ka matlab kya hota hai? It is different from medium, okay? In case of wired communication, medium becomes your wires. In case of wireless communication, the medium becomes air, free space. So medium is completely different from interface. So what is an antenna? It's the interface between radio waves that propagate through space. It can be designed to transmit or receive the waves. Okay, waves are nothing but the energy. Fine. Suppose, how can I compare antenna with your human body? Fine. In your human body, what work your eyes and ears are doing, that is the work of an antenna. Now try to compare, try to analyze what your eyes and ears are doing for you. Aapke kaan aur jo aankh kaam karte hain, wo kaam antenna karta hai. Okay, is it be called a medium? I don't know, I cannot exchange the word medium and the interface. So antenna will work like a ear and eye of a human body. And if you see on the screen, I have written in bracket aerial. So sometimes antenna is interchangeably called aerial. Okay. It is considered as a region of transition between a transmission line and a space. So transmission line ka matlab kya hota hai? Anybody? Aap example denge mujhe. What is a transmission line? I hope this looks like a road. Okay. This is your road, roadside pillars rehte hain, okay, where the wires are hanging, okay, poles jo rehte hain aapke, electric poles, and through this cables are running. Okay, I hope it looks like that, and this portion is called a transmission line, right, which you can see it. While going on roads, these electric poles will be mounted. Electric poles pe jo mounting rehta hai, uske baad jo ye pair of wires, not pair, many wires will be running many times. Multiple lines will be there. They are called the transmission lines. Okay, they carry the information, they carry the signals, and in between will be having many poles. You cannot keep over the same. Okay, you can, if you want to have two poles at two dead ends, extreme ends, then only two poles are not enough. In between, you should have some repeaters also, just to increase or boost the strength of the signal. Now, coming to this point, I have written one point here. The first antennas were built, the first antennas were built in 1888 by a German physicist, Heinrich Hertz. Okay, Hertz, he was working on radio technology. Then after, he was actually following Maxwell's theory. Then after Heinrich Hertz, Marconi then started working on this, and he invented radio. Okay, this is the follow-up, and many people contributed. So antenna is a aerial. It is considered as the region of transition between a transmission line and the space. This I can show it pictorially like this. Okay. This is your transmitter side, and this is your receiver side. Whenever you have a transmitter, from this, if any wave is getting transmitted, these are, assume these two pair of lines are coming out from this transmitting antenna. Inside this, which waves are going, we call them guided waves, because under certain restricted portion they are moving. Okay, they are getting guided through that restricted portion, so they are guided waves. Then after this, this tapering part is there like this. Okay, assume that they are designed like that, two pair of transmission lines. From this portion to this, they are getting tapered, their mouth is getting wide. There, this transition is happening. Okay, up and down, you can see the arrow marks, they indicate the electric field lines. Okay, after when they come out of its mouth, antenna mouth, then they get detached from this mouth and they get a separate entity. This E lines gets wider and wider and wider, and they get into the space. Assume करो ये transmitter है. Transmitter से जब वो उसके mouth से निकलता है, they gets detached. These E lines gets detached. So this part is a guided region. This is the transition region. ये जो tapering part है, जो mouth wide हो रहा है, that is the transition region. And then the electric field lines, they get detached and they get into the free space. That free space is nothing but 3D, three dimensional. Electromagnetic waves gets they get radiated into the space. Hence this term is used, transition between transmission line and space. Okay, from the transmitter till the space, there is a transition. And similarly, at the receiving end, the same thing happens. From this plane wave, the free space wave, whatever is there, it gets transmitted. The transition occurs, and again transition is occurred back to the guided waves. Because again, see here, the field lines, they are getting this arrow marks change whenever they get hit by that particular boundaries. The direction changes, then inside it moves, and at the receiver it gets received. So in between transmitter and the receiver, if we see this figure, antennas are, they act like a transition. They transit the waveforms from one form to the other form. At the transmitter, guided wave to free space wave. At the receiver, free space wave to guided wave back. Okay. So the transmitting antenna is a region, the same thing I have written here. The receiving antenna is a region where the reverse transition takes place. So it's a transition device between the guided wave and the free space wave, or vice versa. This is about the antenna. These two play a major role in microwave engineering and radio engineering. Fine. So this is about your subject titles, microwave and antennas. Now let us move to the module 3. As I had told you in the previous class, I'll start with module 3. In module 3, we will be studying certain parameters. If you look at the screen, I've written here, while choosing an antenna, many parameters should be taken into account before choosing. For example, if you go to a TV shop, you want to purchase a TV. Okay, what all parameters you will keep in your mind before purchasing? Let me know. I think the session will end soon. Quickly answer me so that quickly. What all parameters you will keep in your mind before purchasing a television? Yeah.
Clarity, length.
Oh, very good. Clarity. Then?
Size of the TV.
Size, okay. Not important, bhul gaye. Clarity ho gaya, size ho gaya. Then?
Quality. Cost.
Oh yes, who said that? Very important one. Everything we do, yes, very economic, okay. We Indians are especially very economically, you know, very much very keen on this economicity. So economic viability is very important. It should be, you know, affordable to us. So hence, see, aapke paas, if two people are competitors, the same material, the same whatever product is available at a lower cost, okay, in one of the person's shop, then obviously you'll opt for that, right? Okay, you, as your that person is your friend, you won't go and purchase a high cost value product. Okay, economics is very important. So many factors are there. Likewise, even here, when you're studying antenna basics, why this has been incorporated in your syllabus is, whatever may be the higher ended version products that are coming into market now as the technology is booming, the basic things remains the same. Okay, basic principles remains the same. So in order to choose a proper antenna, in order to design a proper antenna, you have to consider few things into account before that. Those antenna parameters are these. I have listed here, you can check it. Radiation pattern. Okay, as and when we proceed towards one by one, you'll understand what are these parameters. Then gain, efficiency, impedance, shape, size, weight of the antenna, and above all, economic viability. So all these are to be taken into account. So for your study, certain parameters are specified. What each parameter specifies, defines. Okay. The before going for further parameters, this is one point which it cannot be necessary, but still I have included some basic equation for radiation. This is not a parameter. Okay. Just one equation. You should know about this. So I have written. So irregarding of any antenna type, antenna ka type jo bhi ho, koi bhi version ho, anything, the basic principle remains the same. Okay, kitne bhi bengali varieties aapko pata hai, but basic ingredients, basic methodologies remains the same. Okay, just like that. So the principle behind it remains the same, and that basic equation for radiation is this: I dash L is equal to Q into V. I dash is your time changing current, L is the length of the current element. I think you have studied this in your physics, probably intensity part somewhere. Q is the charge, V is the time change of velocity. This is one general equation you should know. Okay, I don't know where it is applicable as for now. When it gets applicable anywhere, I'll let you know. So basic principle behind the radiation, I dash L is equal to Q into V. Now let us start with the first parameter. May not be a direct parameter given, but it is necessary for upcoming topics. So the very first parameter is power density, P. You have studied this power density in electromagnetics, if you remember. I had only taught you electromagnetics. Okay, power density.
I by A.
It was actually that specific thing. It was I by A. That divided by A.